everyone. Do you guys have a great week? I hope so. Well, if you're just joining us for the first time, my name's Danielle Voschel, and I'm one of the people teach about Jesus around here. Well, I want to welcome you to the last day of soccer tryouts. At this point, I've got almost all my roster filled up. I just need one more thing. I need a goalie. Now, depending on who you ask, some people might say the goalie is the most important person on the team. A good goalie can sometimes mean the difference between winning and losing a game. No matter how good the rest of your team is, if you don't have a good goalie, you're not going to win. No matter how good the rest of the team is, if the goalie's not good, it's going to be a really hard time defending your goal, isn't it? Defending the net is important, isn't it? You know, that reminds me of a Bible story. Jesus is the most important part to the church, but in our story today, Paul had to be really important. He had to defend the gospel. He had to defend the truth of the gospel from people that were telling lies about the gospel. And these people were trying to lead people away from the love of Jesus. Well, let's hear that story. Paul has shared the good news about Jesus in Corinth. Many people believed the gospel, and they began meeting together as a church. After Paul left, he heard that the believers in Corinth were turning away from the gospel. Other people had come and taught them things that weren't true. These teachers led the Corinthians away from the one true gospel, and Paul was worried. So Paul wrote a letter to the church. "Listen," Paul wrote, "I care about you. I want you to be faithful to Jesus and to remember the gospel." Paul knew that the people had been tricked by the false teachers, like the serpent in the Garden of Eden had tricked Eve. Eve had everything she needed, but she believed the serpent's lie and disobeyed God. The Corinthian believers had everything they needed, the good news of the gospel, yet they were turning away to listen to the wrong teaching. "I am not a great speaker," Paul admitted, "but I know what I am talking about." Paul relied on God's power to share the gospel. He spent his life sharing the good news, even though it meant facing suffering. Paul didn't share the gospel to get something from those who listened. He told them about Jesus because he loved them. Paul wrote, "I won't back down." False teachers are trying to spread different messages so that the good news about Jesus won't go out. These teachers are against God, and they're only trying to take advantage of you. Paul spoke up because he knew the truth. "If anyone deserves to be listened to, it's me. I worked hard, been thrown in jail and beaten, and nearly died to share the gospel." God had chosen Paul and had changed his life. Paul knew his suffering was worth it, and he wasn't going to give up. "I do all of this because God the Father of the Lord Jesus deserves to be praised."
Well, now it's time for some questions again. Let's see how much you guys learned in the story.
Paul was concerned that the Corinthians would be deceived, just like who?
Yeah, Eve. Remember the serpent tricked her and she ate the fruit? Now, we don't know what kind of fruit it was. Maybe it was banana. The Bible just says fruit. Let's read the Bible verse about that.
"But I am afraid that your minds will lead you away from your true and pure following Christ, just as Eve was tricked by the snake with his evil eyes." 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. What did Paul face because of his desire to share the gospel?
Yeah, Paul suffered lots of different types of sufferings, didn't he? Let's read a Bible verse about all the things that happened to him.
Are they serving Christ? I am serving him more. I am crazy to talk like this. I have worked much harder than they. I have been in prison more often. I have been hurt more in beatings. I have been near death many times. 5 times the Jews have given me their punishment of 39 lashes with a whip. 3 different times I was beaten with rods. One time I was almost stoned to death. Three times I was in ships that wrecked. And one of those times I spent the night and day in the sea. I have gone on many travels and have been in danger from the rivers, thieves, my own people, the Jews, and those who are not Jews. I have been in danger in cities, in places where no one lives, and on the sea. And I have been in danger with false Christians. I have done hard and tiring work, and many times I did not sleep. I have been hungry and thirsty, and many times I have been without food. I have been cold and without clothes. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23-27. Where can we find the truth about God and ourselves?
Yeah, the Bible is the most important thing to learn about God, isn't it? It's literally God's word, so it's the best spot to learn about God's word and His truth, isn't it?
What sufferings might we face if we stand up for the gospel?
Yeah, sometimes people don't treat us very nice. They might think we're not very cool because we go to church. But just like we've been talking about in church, sometimes there's even places where people can't worship Christ freely. Remember what that word is we've been talking about? Persecution. You may be persecuted against because maybe people feel like, you know, we're silly for believing in Christ, but some people can't even go to church. They can't believe in Christ because they'll be put in jail just like Paul was, or even put to death. So we should be thankful that we live in a place where we can worship God.
Where can we get strength to face the persecution and stand up for the gospel?
Just like we talked a few minutes ago, God is our strength. He'll always give us strength, no matter what we're going through. So when people make fun of us for believing in God or think we're weird, remember, God gives us strength. And we can do some pretty cool things for God, can't we? Well, it's the last Sunday of the month, so that means it's the last time to do our Bible story song. So let's sing that song together.
So that he might come to have first place.
You guys are sounding great. You're doing so awesome. I hope that helped you remember the Bible verse this month. Maybe we can do more songs in the future. Well, let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, for all your promises. You have promised to be with us when we share the gospel with others. No matter what the challenges we face, give us courage to tell others about you. Help us to press on, no matter what. Amen. Now on Wednesday, we're going to talk about some questions you might have. And then we're going to learn about churches that celebrate God around the world. I'll see you on Wednesday. Bye!